ओके दिस इज द फर्स्ट वीडियो लेक्चर ऑफ डिजिटल सिग्नल प्रोसेसिंग क्लियर दिस इज द फर्स्ट वीडियो लेक्चर ऑफ डिजिटल सिग्नल प्रोसेसिंग डिजिटल सिग्नल डिजिटल सिग्नल प्रोसेसिंग क्लियर नाउ बिफोर गोइंग टू सिग्नल प्रोसेसिंग इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू अंडरस्टैंड what is signal because in the digital signal processing first the important thing is here the signal part because you are processing the signal then for processing what required one system clear here three part is there digital signal processing actually here we are processing according to this full form digital signal processing we are processing a digital signal but actually this is a discrete time signal processing I want to say this is your discrete time signal processing because here we will process the discrete signal in this subject DSP digital signal processing we will process the discrete time signal instead of digital signal clear now the important part is the signal first you should understand what is signal once you will understand what is signal then you can go to the this processing part you can go to the processing part in the processing part we required one system if you see in this processing part we required one system to process the signal clear to process the signal that's why I given the topic signal and system the main purpose of this name signal and system is we are interested to process a signal and how to process we can process through a system we are really interested to process a signal and how will process we can process through a system okay so we will see one by one first what is signal then what is system then we can go to the processing part how to process a signal okay this processing is how to process already I said that with the help of system we are processing but again we will discuss more detail how to process a signal clear now first is what is signal this is the first part we should understand what is a signal now already I given this definition signal is a physical quantity varies with independent variable contain some information clear what do you mean signal is a physical quantity or you can say physical phenomena varies with independent variable and contain some information so what is independent here the two important thing one is the independent variable and second one is the information what is independent variable means already I given this is your time is one independent variable because time depends on nothing, but everyone depends on time. So you can say time is one independent variable. Okay, time is one independent variable. Similarly, space, we can say another space. Space also one independent variable. Because space also depends on nothing, everyone depends on space. Clear? So simple, a signal is a physical quantity of physical phenomenon which varies with some independent variable. And the second important part is the information. It contains some information. It is a very, very, very important part. It contains some information. Clear? Now, as an engineer, it is our responsible, our duty to extract that information. Sometimes it is very easy to extract the information, and sometimes it is it's very, very difficult to extract the information, and sometimes it is it looks highly impossible to extract the information. But our task is to extract the information. This is very, very important. Okay, this information part is very, very important. How you are extracting information? So many methods are there. You have to use your own method also to extract information, but it is very important to extract the information. We can say that in case of deterministic signal, if you take for this information point of view, if you want to discuss, if you take one deterministic signal that I am writing, deterministic signal, another we can write some random signal. Just if you take these two example, one is your deterministic signal, another is your random signal. Clear? Now, in case of deterministic signal means it can represent by a mathematical model, or some mathematical form is there. So for deterministic signal, it is if you study the deterministic signal up to some certain instant of time, then you can predict the future value also, or you can predict the future thing, but that is not possible in case of random signal. Clear? So we can say that for deterministic signal, it is easy to extract the information, but in case of random signal, it is difficult. In case of random signal, it is difficult. I want to say like this. In case of now, in case of deterministic signal, it is easy to extract the information, means having some mathematical model. If you take x of t equals to some sine t, so this is one deterministic signal having some mathematical model, or you can say x of t equals to something t square plus 2, anything you can take. Having some mathematical model. Now, in this deterministic signal, we can find the value of signal at any instant of time. Clear? Means if someone asks what is the value of the signal at t equals to 2, then we can say it is x of 2 equals to sine 2, and by using calculator you can find this value of sine 2. If someone asks what is the value of signal at a t equals to something 5 second, then x of 3 equals to sine 3 means if you give plot also, it is you all people know okay. Now my point is here, if in this case, let I am giving some point like this 0, let t1, this t2, something t3, and it also will continue. My point is here, if you get this type of signal, then if you see, just this is also periodic signal, but I want to discuss in terms of deterministic signal. Now if you see in this case, my point is here, if you know the value of x of t up to some certain point, let up to some point t2, up to some point t2, you know the value of the signal. If you know the value of the signal, then we can predict for next we can predict the value of the signal for next means time, like t3. Also you can predict for the future value of time, or if you take let this is t4 also, t4, similarly t5, and this values if you want to take something, let 0 2 4 6, you take randomly 8. Okay, means my point is here, This is a deterministic signal. My point is here is, if you have deterministic signal, if you know the value of deterministic signal up to some certain instant of time, then from that you can predict the future value also. Means if you know some past value or the value of the signal up to some present value, then also you can predict the future value. You can predict the future value. So that is a deterministic signal. Similarly, in case of x of t equals to t square plus 2, if you plot also, same, someone will ask what is the value of x of t for t equals to 1, means x of 1 equals to 1 square plus 2, this is 1 plus 2 means 3. Similarly, t equals to 2, it is x of 2 equals to 2 square plus 2, 4 plus 2, 6. So my point is here, I given directly the equation. Instead of equation, if you have some waveform also, let if you take simple x of t equals to t square. Okay, if you take some simple x of t equals to t square, and if you want to plot it, okay, like this is the plot. Now, if you have this type of plot with you, and let you know this is 0, you know the value of this signal up to some time t1, okay, up to some time t1, then not required to know all this value, you can easily predict accurately for this example, some up to value t2, if you take T3 and so on. Clear? So this is the deterministic signal. Means from this we can say easily that it is easy to extract the information about the signal if it is deterministic. Okay. If you want, you can take so many examples. Simply, a deterministic signal is represented by mathematical model. It's represented by mathematical model, and it is easy to extract the information. And if you have some certain, if you have value of that signal up to certain instant of time, you can predict for the future value also. Clear? Now, if you take some random signal, then what you can say, random signal means the name itself is random. So if you have some random signal, let I will give some random signal. Okay, like this, it will continue. Now, this up to time 0, and let this is some random signal x of t. Okay, now if you see this signal is not periodic, means not repeats, and also if you see this signal, it is highly difficult to represent by mathematical model. Okay, by using some mathematical model and programming, we can generate a signal which looks like random, which can looks like random. Means my point is here, if you use MATLAB, some one command is there, rand command is there, rand, rand command, and similarly, okay, similarly rand and command is there. Okay, means this commands it's using to generate some random sequence. Okay, so my point is here, we can generate a random signal, means it will looks like a random signal by using program, but actually it is not random because it is a fixed program. So according to program you are getting the signal, but if you really see a random signal, it is very difficult to predict. I will give one best example of random signal, what you are thinking. What you are thinking, see, now you know that our mind, it's a very fluctuating thing. Okay, it's fluctuating every time, it's very difficult to control our mind. Now we don't know what we will think after some certain instant of time. Even we don't know, means what type of thinking process will come in our mind according to time, because it depends upon the situation and the environment. So it is really difficult, really difficult. We can estimate up to some value, but it is really difficult to predict the future thinking process of any human being. Okay. Otherwise, we can say that our ECG signal also, okay, what you are thinking, or if you take your ECG signal, or if you want to take the dreams, what you are dreaming, okay, what you are dreaming. Now, these all things, or we can say simple, the future prediction about rain or something. Any future prediction, if you take also any future prediction, the word future itself is a random signal. Okay, because we don't know what will happen in the future, so the word future itself is a random signal. Okay, why given AC signal, what will happen to us, we don't know after some certain instant of time. Okay, we may live, we may die, or anything can happen. So it will affect our heartbeat, and according to that, this signal. Clear? Now, if you say, means random signal, it is highly difficult to predict the future value of a random signal or future thing of a random signal. That's why the name itself is a random. Okay. So many things we can say that just I given what you're thinking, is a signal and dreaming, all this part, but we can take so many things for random signal. Now, and it is highly difficult to represent mathematically, yes or not? It is highly difficult, okay, to represent in a model. Model means I am saying that mathematical model. Like here, you are given one mathematical model, na? You are giving the mathematical model x of t equals to sin t or x of t equals to t square plus 2, mathematical model. So it is difficult. There is no doubt it is difficult. Now if you see, here in case of a random signal, if you see here, just in this graph, okay. In this graph, even though these all are the past values, even though you know all the past values, even though you know all the values up to this instant of time 0, or you can take any other instant, let this t1, okay. If you know all these values, if you take the t1 is the present time, then these all will come to past, okay. Even though you know the value of the signal up to some instant t1, it is difficult, or it looks like impossible to predict the future value. Okay, clear? So this is about a random signal. It's highly difficult to represent mathematically, and also it is highly difficult to extract the information, and it also highly difficult to predict the information for future. Okay, so this is about random signal. Clear? So deterministic signal is something you can represent in mathematical model, and random signal, it is very difficult to represent in mathematical model. And unfortunately, we all are dealing with the random signal only. Okay, we all are dealing with random signal only because we don't know what will happen in future, like this COVID. Who knows? Suddenly it started. We stuck in our home. Clear? So anything can happen. And our signal generally, maximum signals are random only. And we are really interested on random signal only. There is no point, because if the signal is deterministic, there is no interest. If you know everything, then there is no interest in the life. So some randomness required, and actually it is random only. Clear? Like what you will do tomorrow, or anything, means so many things are coming now. So what will come in tomorrow also we don't know. Some more and more challenges are coming. Clear? So when some more challenges are coming, because of randomness, we are really excited about life. If not, it is difficult. Our all signals are random signal. Okay. Now this is about deterministic and random signal. We are not much interest to go more depth again. I think you people understand what is deterministic and random signal. And our point is here, just I say that in case of deterministic signal, it is easy to extract the information, but in case of random signal, it is difficult. It is difficult to extract the information. Okay, but unfortunately, we are dealing with the random signal only. Okay, now I think you all people clear what is signal. So signal is a physical quantity, varies with some independent variable time space, and contain some information. And just I given the idea about two type of signal, deterministic signal and random signal. So many more categories is there. I don't want to go there, but this is essential, deterministic and random signal. Now based on independent variable, because here one term we use, this is your independent variable, that is time space. Generally in our subject, we will deal with time only, not space, time. Now, come to independent variable. Based on independent variable, we can categorize signal into two parts. One is one-dimensional signal. Another is a multi-dimensional signal. Okay. One-dimensional and multi-dimensional signal. Now, what is one-dimensional signal? If the signal have only single independent variable, just now I given. Okay, so one dimension signal means it is having single independent variable. Okay, this is just as one example I given, x of t equals to t square plus 1. If you see here single, here t is a single independent variable. Okay, clear? So whenever the signal having single independent variable, that is known as a one dimensional signal. Just I given the sine t you take, or AC signal, or our simple ACG signal. Okay, simple, we can say it's a function of some independent variable, single independent variable. This is function of this dot. This dot is here, single independent variable. Okay, single independent variable. Now if you see, then this type of signal is known as a one dimensional signal. Now whenever some more independent variable present, like here I given, then it is known as a multi dimensional signal. For example, I given here x of t1 t2 equals to t1 square plus t2 square. If you see, I given this number also 1 2. Here t1 is a one independent variable, t2 another independent variable. So it is function of two independent variable. So we can say it is a two dimensional signal. But here since it is more than one, that's why I use the word multi dimensional signal. Okay, I am using the word multi dimensional signal. Clear? Now similarly, x of t1, t2, t3. This is some random equation I am writing. This is some random equation I am writing. So if you see, these are the multidimensional signal. And if you take the example of multidimensional signal, we can say it is an image signal. It is a multidimensional signal. Okay, image signal. It having a function of two, that's two dimensional signal. It is intensity and brightness, it's coming. So that is an image signal. Okay, it is a multi-dimensional signal. And also you can say that video signal. Okay, image signal means simple one frame, video signal means more than one frame. And another parameter is there, when more than one frame process with a very certain interval of time, then the image signal become video signal. Okay, the image signal become video signal. So these are the example of multi-dimension. This is we can say two-dimensional signal, and this is also a three-dimensional signal. Clear? Now this is given in general, x of t1, t2, t3 up to tn, these all are multi-dimensional signal. Example, this function of, here if you see, here what is the number of independent variables, n number of independent variables, yes or not? This t1, t2, this tn, these are the n number of independent variables. N number of independent variable. Okay, so n number of independent variable, so this is a multi-dimensional signal. I hope you people clear. Okay, I started with what is signal. Okay, just if you want some review part also, I'll say that quickly. See, our topic is DSP. Actually, it is the full form of digital signal processing, but actually it is discrete time signal processing. Okay, now two things are very, very important. One is signal and another is processing. That's why I taken signal. And for the processing part, I taken system, because to process any signal, the one physical device required. Okay, that is known as a system. Clear? So that's why I given the topic signal and system. Signal, here signal means in general, but my interest is discrete time signal. Later I will go to that part, but just we gone through till now what is signal, and later we will go through the complete discrete time signal, and system also we'll discuss. Okay, how we are processing signal, that part also we'll discuss later. Okay, now this is, you people understand what is signal, a physical phenomenon, varies with some independent variable and contains some information. This information is the hiding part you have to extract. Okay, this is your, you can say, hiding part we have to extract. Then I just give a brief explanation of deterministic signal and random signal. Okay, now after that, based on number of independent variable, I categorize one dimensional and multi dimensional. If only single independent variable present, then it is one dimensional signal, and more independent variable present, then it is a multi dimensional signal. More than one, more means here more than one. Okay, more than one, then it is multi dimensional signal. And we've seen some example also. Okay, like your AC signal, simple function sin t, AC signal, these are one dimension signal. And if you take image signal, okay, then we discuss that image signal is a two dimension signal, that intensity and brightness, and video signal, it is a three-dimensional signal. Same, the difference between image and video signal, when you process the image signal, then it is a video signal. Clear? Now this is a multi-dimensional signal. X is a multi-dimensional signal with n number of independent variable, t1, t2, up to tn. Clear? Now come to, okay, now if you, that part is over. Now actually, how you can categorize the signal? That based on number of independent variable, but we are more interested in the time. So based on, again, this time particularly, we are categorizing like this. It's a analog signal or continuous time signal, discrete time signal. These are the required part. And digital signal. Okay, again I want to remind you people, we will deal more with the discrete time signal. Okay, because this is a discrete time signal processing. Okay, so we will deal more with the discrete time signal only. This is our required part. And digital signal. Now what is analog signal? We'll go one by one. Analog signal, this is also known as continuous time signal. As a definition I given, analog signal are defined for all values of time. Okay, there is no break. Clear? There is a no break. If you see here, this is just an example of an analog signal. This is an analog signal. Now if you see this signal, see here I taken this interval t1 and t2. Clear? If you see this signal in interval t1 t2, See, in this between interval T1 and T2, the signal is continuous with respect to time. Continuous with respect to time means there is no break. There is a no break. So this is a continuous time signal. This is a continuous time signal. And our definition, this continuous time signal defined for all value of time means you take any two interval, let this T1 is something 0 second, and this T2 is let something 10 second. So in this interval 0 to 10 second we can define the signal for any value of time. Any value of time means how many values present in between 0 to 10? I want to say there are infinite number of values are present, yes or not? Simple. Means it's very simple. 0.1, 0.001, 0.001, like this. Itself in between 0.0 to 0.1, there are infinite number of points, yes or not? So we can say that for analog signal or continuous time signal, in between any two interval there are infinite number of points available. Okay, that's why it is said that analog signal are defined for all values of time t. Okay, clear? There is no break point. And the second point is there are infinite number of points exist in between t1 and T2, you can take any two value, infinite number of points exist. Okay, and this is just one example. Or if you want to take a sinusoidal signal, this is also a continuous time signal. Okay, clear? Or any, just if you want to give anything, just any random signal. Clear? This limit you can take anything starting from 0. Here let anything you can take 20, 30, 40, whatever your wish you take. This is something later 20, 30, 10. Okay. The point is here, in this interval 0 to 40, it is, or you can take any short interval also, 0 to 10 or 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 0 to 30, you will get it is continuous by nature. It is a continuous by nature. Clear? So this is about our analog signal or continuous time signal. Okay, same, this is a analog signal. I just taken the interval 2.35, and if you see in between 3 and 5 the signal is continuous by nature, there is no break. Let's see here. Okay, here also in between 3 and 5 there are infinite number of points. Clear? Now come to discrete time signal. Now the analog signal is over. Okay, maximum signal are analog by nature only. Like see what I are speaking, space signal. Okay. Means if you see our maximum signals are the natural signal, all natural signals, everything are analog by nature. Okay, now come to discrete time signal. Discrete time signal, if you see the definition, discrete time signals defined at discrete instant of time. the discrete instant of time, and it is represented by x of n or y of n or z of n, anything. Like here, the analog signal represented by x of t, y of t, z of t, like this. Okay, so this is it's not important, you can take anything, or p of t, q of t, anything you can take. Just 1 minute. Okay, now, and this is just I given one example, x of n equals to c, or again I will write a discrete time signal. Okay, so this is one discrete time signal. If you see here, see at 0 it is 1, at 1 it is 2, at 2 it is 0.8. Just I am taking some random value, 3 0.5, 4 1.4, 5 1.9, 6 0.75, like this. If you want to give more also, you can give. Okay, now the discrete time signal represented by x of n or y of n or p of n or q of n, something function of n, and this n varies from n equals to 0, plus or minus 1, plus or minus 2, plus or minus 3, like this. Clear? Okay. It will go up to infinity. Clear? Now if you see, this is a discrete time signal. According to our definition, discrete time signal defined at discrete value of t or at instant of time. Now see, if you notice here, this value defined, this signal, discrete time signal defined only for 0, plus or minus 1, plus or minus 2, plus or minus 3, like this. But in between 0 and 1, not exist, means 0. In between 1 and 2, again it is 0. Means this discrete time signal not defined for all value of time. Only discrete instant of time. Discrete instant of time is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. If you want to take also, this also giving dot dot. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, like this. So it is not continuous by nature, it is discrete by nature. Okay, so this is a discrete time signal. Clear? Now means here the value of x of n not exists for all value of n like t. So in case of continuous time signal, it is represented by x of t, but t is minus infinity to plus infinity, yes or not? You can take any value of t, but in case of discrete time signal x of n, you cannot take all value of n. It's bounded. Means you have to take 0, means one discrete value or integers, 0, plus or minus 1, plus or minus 2, plus or minus 3, like this. Okay. Again. Okay, again, if you see the discrete time signal, it is two type. One is a discrete by nature. Second one is a okay, the first one is a discrete by nature, second one is a discrete representation of a continuous time signal. Okay, some signals like here I given this example, this is a discrete by, this is discrete by nature. Okay, but some signal is not discrete. Actually, we know that our all signals are continuous by nature. So what we are doing, we are converting that continuous time signal to discrete form, that is known as your sampling, and it comes under the second category as discrete representation of continuous time signal. Okay, discrete representation of continuous time signal. Like if you see, if you categorize now. Discrete by nature, what I can say that example, if you take, you can say depositing money in a bank in every month. like some amount okay January February March April May June July August September October November December So if you see you can represent this is March okay January February March April May June July this is August September October this is November December so this is comes under discrete by nature if you take another example temperature recording of a room in interval of 1 hour temperature okay this also can say it is a if you want to represent let 6 I start from 6 a.m. up to let's say it is a okay 6 a.m. 7 a.m. 8 9 10 11 12 let this is 1 p.m. you take some values okay it's not let 28 30 27 35 29 okay like this values now this is also discrete by nature here I am recording the temperature from 6 a.m. temperature of a room from 6 a.m. to 1 p.m. in the interval of 1 hour okay in the interval of 1 hour means 6 then next 1 hour is 7 after 1 hour is 8 then 9 10 okay clear so this is also discrete by nature it comes under discrete by nature clear and but this is okay but important thing is the second part what is the second part is a discrete representation of continuous time signal that is very very important See, this is discrete representation of a continuous time signal. Means here, actually we have analog signal with you. See, I want to say, you have this is analog signal with you. Now what to do? This analog signal, when now I want to. Represent this analog signal means I want to convert this analog signal to discrete signal okay now what I did see I have analog signal with me. Okay, this is a continuous time signal. And what I will do, I want to convert this analog signal to discrete signal. Okay, for that what I will do, I will multiply this analog signal with impulse train. This is a impulse train. Okay, already people read in the signal system what is impulse train and what is impulse signal. Okay, I don't want to go again. So simple, when analog signal multiply with an impulse train, so what you are getting, we are getting like this. Yes or not? That's this interval impulse train 0 TS 2 TS, if you want to, this also minus TS, then we'll get some value. Okay. Or I want to show you differently. See, let you have analog signal like this. Now what I will do, this is your impulse train. Zero TS, two TS, three TS. Okay. Now simple, what to do? Do multiplication. If you do multiplication, what will get? See that this is your x of t. Then 0, and you know that this one is area of impulse signal. It's because it's minus infinity to plus infinity. Now if you multiply, what these values at 0 means, what is this value x0? What is this value? XTS. This is your X 2TS. This is X 3TS. This is X 4TS. And finally, this is like this. Now when you multiply, what will get? It's very easy, simple multiplication. Now here you will get, here this is your 0, and what is this value? X0, and this is your TS, and what this value? XTS. Two TS. Three TS. Yes. So this is your X of 5 TS. this is x of 4 ts, okay, this is x of 3 ts. Now see, this is your analog signal. Now what signal you got here? This is your discrete time signal. Okay. Now here, this signal, this discrete time signal is not by nature. Means it's not natural. Sorry, not nature. It's not natural discrete time signal or discrete time signal, not by nature. It is a discrete representation of analog signal. Okay, this is x of n. This is a discrete representation of analog signal. That comes under second category. Yes, discrete representation of discrete representation of analog signal, not discrete by nature. Okay, now so this is the process of converting analog signal to discrete signal, and this is known as sampling. This process is known as sampling. Sampling is the process of converting analog signal to discrete signal. Okay, this process is known as sampling. And what is the relationship between x of t and x of n? I want to say x of n equals to x of t for t equals to n ts, or it is x of n ts. This is very, very important. Okay, so this is your discrete signal. This is your analog signal, and we are getting this discrete signal from analog signal. So what is the simple process? Simple is replace t by n ts, and where n is 0, plus or minus 1, plus or minus 2, dot 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 up to infinity. And what is ts? Is a sampling period. Okay, clear? Now this is your discrete representation of analog signal. Clear? I hope you people understand what is analog signal. First of all, what is signal? Then what is analog signal and what is discrete signal, and also how can convert analog signal to discrete signal. Okay, for today, thank you. We'll see some more topics like digital signal, what is digital signal, and how we'll get digital signal from analog signal. Then some more things are there of digital signal processing. Clear? I think up to it is clear to all people. Thank you so much. We will see in the next video.